how to manage the zinc to copper ratio.
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Sharon Schultz says, is there any way we can know our zinc copper ratio is optimal without testing? No, and I don't agree with using the zinc copper ratio in testing. So it is the case that zinc and copper need to be in a very loose range of ratios. So you don't want your dietary zinc to be more than 15 times your dietary copper, and you don't want your dietary zinc to be less than 2 times your dietary copper. But other than that, you're really looking at them individually, and you're looking at, you know, do I have enough zinc? Do I have enough copper? Do I have signs of zinc deficiency? Do I have signs of copper deficiency? Do I have signs of too much of one or the other? Much more than you're looking at the ratio. And in plasma, I think the ratio just reflects disease responses. For example, inflammation will suck zinc into cells and mobilize copper out of the liver. And so it's going to lower the zinc to copper ratio in plasma. And I don't think that has anything to do with nutrition. I think it can be a marker in observational studies of disease processes. I don't think it's a useful clinical marker, except as a, you know, hey, something's wrong here, let's look at inflammation markers, but why not just look at inflammation markers? In blood testing, I really would only want to see plasma zinc around 100 to 120 and plasma copper fairly close to the middle of the range, pretty similar at 100 to 120, generally speaking. And in the diet, I would want to see a ratio of zinc to copper at least 2 to 1, no more than 15 to 1, and otherwise just manage them individually. Thank you, Sharon, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount.
From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book.
In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.